children to come forward now, and they have another musical gift for the, for our graduates.
Thank you.
and leading in a prayer of blessing over each one of our graduating seniors. As well, I'd like to invite Kathy Moulton and Glenn Gordon to come and join me. And what we want to do tonight is pray a blessing on these seniors, but also minister to them prophetically. God has plans and purposes for each of these young people, and we believe that by the Spirit of God, they can receive the heart of God through prophetic ministry tonight. So I want you to be open with us tonight for whatever God may say, to confirm, to build, to encourage our graduates. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Reggie, I would like you to pray the Father's blessing over your daughter to begin with tonight, if you could.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I ask you to bless the rest of your life that you want to. We look after you. We help you to save. Thank you, Jesus.
Robert, you were the first one I got a word for like a week ago. And the word, I thought thought of tonight, and I thought of Gary, and the word that came was lighthouse. And there were two things about the lighthouse. One was that a lighthouse, the light from a lighthouse penetrates the darkness to guide the worn ships of danger. And the Lord just spoke to me that you're going to guide people, and you're going to warn people of danger. If they're doing things contrary to the word of God, you're going to speak up. You're not going to be afraid to speak up and speak into people's lives. And the second thing was, stand alone. And the Lord just showed me you stood alone many times in your convictions. And you even felt lonely. You felt very lonely, very lonely. And the scripture the Lord gave me was Joshua 1:9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
I have branded you with my own thumbprint. I have separated you from birth unto myself. You've looked around and you've cried and said, why am I different? Why am I even strange? And why am I an outcast? Because I have separated you unto myself from the very womb, saith the Lord. And I have called you to stand alone and to be strong. Not to be haughty, not to be above others, but to serve others with your difference and your uniqueness. I have taught you to cry out upon me when you thought there was no tomorrow. I have called you to myself and I have branded you as mine. Don't let the world take you away. Don't let what others would say to you cause you to think differently or to think strangely or to pull away. I have called you to stand in the fires and the heats humbly before me and to call upon me not only for healing and strength, but call upon me for your mind and your thoughts. That I would speak through you, not your own feelings, not your own beliefs or your own thoughts, but that my words would be planted within you. There would be words of grace, words of tenderness. I've not called you to be strong, that you could be forceful or haughty, but I've called you to be strong so that you can support others. Do not question what I'm doing in your life. And do not look at me and shake the finger and say, not me, but not me. I've had enough. Because I say to you that I am forging you in a furnace for the years to come. And I will bring grace into your life. There'll come a time when you sit down and you say, you know, God, I thank you for those years. I thank you for those years. Though it not be yet that you can do that, look forward, son. Because I've separated you